Hi folks, nice to be with you today. Good to be with you. We're here to hear the word of God. The word of God says this: whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Revelation chapter 20 verse 15. The Bible says there is a lake of fire.
Clear.
And God is a holy God. And you don't want to go to hell and meet a holy God. A holy God, pure and white and pure. A holy God who hates sin. But he hated sin so much that he has to judge. He is a righteous God and a just God. So instead of judging you, if you have lied, if you have sinned, if you have done anything wrong, instead of God punishing you, Jesus Christ died on that cross and he died for you. He said, I give my life a ransom for many. He said, he says in the Bible, the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. And my friend, that's what you need today. You need the blood of Christ. One day you'll die, and when you die, you'll go to hell or heaven. And if you're in hell, you'll be crying and saying, get me out, get me out. Your porn, your drugs, your sex, you're getting drunk, and all these things would have sent you there to hell. But Christ loved you, and Christ died for you on that cross. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. God has said, whosoever has sinned against me, I will blot him out of my book. If you sin against God, you'll be blotted out. My friend, I've never met you before, but I know one thing about you: you're going to die. And when you die, Prophet Muhammad will not help you. When you die, Charles Darwin will not help you. When you die, a Buddha will not help you. The only person that will help you is Jesus. For he said, I am the resurrection and the life. A Buddha is dead. His bones are in the ground. Charles Darwin is dead. His bones are in the ground. And Muhammad is dead. And his bones are in the ground. But Jesus died and rose again, my friend. And if you want to conquer death, if you want to go to heaven, if you want to be in heaven for glory, my friend, you have to believe in Jesus. It's no good running away. You're running away from God. You're running away with religion. You're running away with sex. You're running away with alcohol. You're running away with drugs. You're running away from God. But God wants you today. God loves you today. God wants to save you today. He wants to bring you home. So please look to Jesus today. In the Word of God, it says, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. It says that in Romans chapter 3, verse 23. All fall short of the glory of God. You fall short of the glory of God. Every time you lie, every time you steal, every time you sleep around, you fall short of the glory of God. You become guilty before God. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him, God, a liar, and his word is not in us. If we say that we have not sinned, if we say that we have not done any wrong, then we call in God a liar. God says every single one of us, are you okay, brother?
And I can ask you a question? Jesus Christ died for you, bro. You're a sinner, I'm a sinner, and Christ died on that cross. Where's Prophet Muhammad now? Where is he, bro? Where is he? Where is he, bro? Where is the Prophet Muhammad? Where is he? He's dead. Is he dead? Is he dead? He's dead. He's dead. Prophet Muhammad is dead. Jesus Christ died and rose again. He conquered death. And if you want to know life, if you want to know a future, you come to know Jesus. He says in Colossians chapter 2, verse 14, having wiped out the handwriting of requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us, He has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross. Christ died on that cross, and he shed his blood. And our sin was nailed on that cross. The things that you and I did were nailed on that cross. The things that you did and I did were nailed to that cross. Your sin, my sin, was nailed to that cross. Jesus Christ shed his blood, died on that cross, and shed his blood that you may live. He was broken for you on that cross that you may live. He died on that cross that you may live. And if you want to be saved today, you need to know that Christ died for you. There's no other way to be saved. Muhammad cannot save you. Buddha cannot save you. Charles Darwin cannot save you. They cannot save you. The only person that can save you is Jesus Christ. Why? Because... Excuse me. Are you a Muslim extremist or are you a Muslim? If you're a Muslim, be quiet. If you're a Muslim extremist, be a silly boy. Yeah? Jesus Christ died on that cross and shed his blood for you on that cross and gave his life. And if you die tonight without Christ, you're lost. Why? I'll tell you why. Because he's a beautiful Savior. He's a beautiful Lord. He's so beautiful, so holy, so pure. Did the Prophet Muhammad sin? Did the Prophet Muhammad sin? He sinned. He sinned. He sinned. He said, worship three gods. He read about it. He said, worship three gods. He said, and he repented. Now, did Jesus sin? Did Jesus sin? My friend, did Jesus sin?
We believe in one God.
Did Jesus sin? Did the Prophet Muhammad sin? Did the Prophet Muhammad sin?
You believe in one God? I believe in one.
No, the Prophet Muhammad sinned. He committed a sin. He said, worship three gods.
Where?
He says it. You can read it in Tabari. You want to get Tabari? We have the literature, yeah?
Tabari.
He sinned against God. He sinned against God. My friend will get you the evidence. But Jesus never sinned. Jesus never sinned. He never sinned. He was pure. He was pure. He was pure. Now, how many wives did Muhammad have? He needed women. Jesus never needed a woman. Jesus was pure and holy and lived a pure and holy life and shed his blood as the Lamb of God for you. My Muslim friends, wake up. Jesus loves you. He died for you. And you're living in darkness. You're living in darkness. Your mind has been perverted by a false religion. And you need to wake up and realize that Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the way. Jesus is light. Jesus is light and pure and holy. And that is who you need today. Muhammad has sinned. Muhammad sinned. Jesus never sinned. Muhammad sinned. But Jesus never sinned. He never sinned. We have the evidence. We have the evidence. Oh, sir, are you a Muslim extremist or a Muslim?
You remember me?
Are you a Muslim? Are you a Muslim?
Yes, in your donkey. What is this?
Are you? Are you a Muslim extremist or are you a Muslim?
You was mum. You was mum.
Are you a Muslim extremist? Are you a Muslim extremist or a Muslim?
All Muslim love everyone.
Are you a Muslim?
All Muslim love everyone.
A Muslim extremist.
All Muslim love everybody.
Muhammad sinned. Muhammad sinned. Muhammad sinned. He said, worship three gods. Jesus Christ never sinned.
You liar.
The shed is blood.
Only Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, number one.
Jesus Christ died on that cross. He shed his blood on that cross. Muhammad never died for you. Muhammad wanted bounty. My friend, Jesus Christ loved you. He died for you. My friend, as a Muslim, Muslim hate preachers here. We don't do hate, we do love. Muslim hate preachers here. Muslim hate preachers. We don't do hate preachers, we do love. Jesus Christ loved you and died for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you. Now, here. I'll become a Muslim now. I'll become a Muslim. Are you a Muslim?
No, we're not going to follow.
Is he a Muslim?
Yeah, but I'm a Muslim.
Are you a Muslim extremist, sir?
Alhamdulillah.
He's a Muslim extremist. He's a Muslim extremist. Now, listen to this, my friends. Yes. Listen to this. When you die as a Muslim, what do you get? What do you get? What do you get as a Muslim extremist? What do you get when you die?
Not metro.
You get virgins. You get virgins. What do you get as a Christian? What do you get as a Christian when you die? What do you get as a Christian when you die? You get eternal life. When you're a Muslim, you get virgins. But what do the women get? The men get virgins. The men get all the virgins they want.
Allah.
And they get all the drink. What's that? Did Muhammad say he said worship three gods? We have it here, Tabari, in Tabari. He said that your prophet Muhammad has the Quran changed? Has the Quran changed? Yes, the Quran has changed. Let me tell you this. There are verses that should be in the Quran. That are not in the Quran. Did you know that?
How many books are you?
Are you a Muslim extremist, sir?
I have only one book. Quran and Kareem.
I think he's a Muslim extremist.
And Quran and Kareem.
Prophet Muhammad said, worship three gods. Worship three gods. Look, Jesus Christ is the perfect Savior, the perfect Lord, the one who loved you, the one who shed his blood for you, the one who gave his life for you. So trust him as your Lord, trust him as your Savior. That's what you need today. You need Jesus Christ as Lord, you need Jesus Christ as Savior, you need Jesus Christ as King. You need him today. You need his love. You need his love today. You need the love of Christ. Muhammad never loved you. He never died for you. Did Muhammad die for you?
Who said that?
Did he die for you?
Who said that?
Did Muhammad die for you?
Who said that?
Did Muhammad die for you?
Answer me, mate.
Jesus loved you. Jesus died for you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Muhammad never died for you. The atheist never died for you. Richard Dawkins doesn't want to die for you. He's making millions of pounds selling his books. Muhammad wanted booty. When he went to war, he had booty. He had women. He had money. Jesus never had anything. He died for you. He loved you. He shed his blood for you. Now, has the Bible changed, Muslim? Has the Bible changed? Right, okay, let's test the Muslims. Surah 634. Muslims, come on. Surah 634. You don't even know your own Qurans. You don't even know your own Qurans, for goodness sake. Surah 634, what does it say? You're the guys who say you have chain of narration, memorization. Have you memorized Surah 634? What does it say? There are Muslim young scholars here. What does Surah 634 say?
It says something good.
I tell you what it says. It says this: my words cannot change. And that's in the relationship with the Bible. It's not about the Bible. It's not about the prophets. So when you as a Muslim say the Bible's changed, your own Quran says it's not changed. So what are you going on about? Now, here's another one, Muslims. Here's another one. You say the Quran has been passed on by memorization. We have a hadith where the Prophet Muhammad forgot a surah. He forgot a surah. So how can the Quran be passed on by memorization when the Prophet Muhammad couldn't remember his own Quran? You wear that one out, guys.
Are you an ex-drinker?
Jesus Christ died for you, my friend. One day you're going to die. And when you die, you're going to meet your maker. And Lord, my Lord loves you. My Lord died for you. My Lord loved you, my friend. He loved you and died for you. He shed his blood for you, my friend. He gave his life for you. So trust him as your Lord. Trust him as your Savior. He loved you. He died for you. When you die, you're going to go to hell. You're going to go to hell. If you don't know Jesus, you're going to go to hell.
What's wrong with hell?
You need Christ, who loved you and died for you and shed his blood. And Muslims, you've been deluded. I know it's hurtful to say.
Why should I disagree with the Jews and Persians?
You've been deluded, my Muslim friends. You're deluded. And these Muslim apologists, they can't debate. These Muslim apologists, if you look at them, they always pick on young Christians. They don't come and pick on me or my team. They're cowards. They're a bunch of cowards. They're a bunch of cowards. They go and pick on Christians who don't know anything. Yeah? So they're cowards. And then they make their YouTube videos and then they say how great we are, how wonderful we are as Muslim apologists because they pick on young Christians. You need Jesus. God bless you.
You pick on your Lord.
No, you need Jesus. God bless you. Lord, you need Jesus. You need the Lord today. You need Christ. You need him. I read one last scripture.
Jesus' right hand man.
His own self bore our sins in his own body on the tree. He bore your sins on the tree. Put the Quran away, put Muhammad away, and put your faith in Jesus Christ. He was crucified, he shed his blood. I'm telling you the truth. How come, if I'm lying, why are your Muslim apologists challenging me? Why are your Muslim apologists challenging me? Because they're cowards. They're cowards. They can't debate. Come on. See, where are they?
I don't know where you are.
Where are they? They can't debate me.
Allah.
They're cowards.
Allah.
They can't debate us. They pick on young Christians. They pick on young Christians. And then they send people like this. They send people like this to bully them. They don't debate in a fair, honest way. They don't debate in a fair, honest way. They can't debate. They pick on young Christians.
Liars.
And they get their videos and they put it on YouTube and they think they're so clever and so smart. I have a degree in theology. Not one Muslim here apart from Paul Williams has any qualification. They don't know anything. Jesus Christ shed his blood. He gave his life for you. He shed his blood for you. He gave his life. He died for you. He gave his life. Trust him as your Lord and Savior. My friends, if you die tonight and go to hell, I'll be crying. I'll be sad. Because you need Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. God bless you. Have a lovely day. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Excuse me, church is open.